Hello.
Hello.
Mr. Hilton.
Ah, yes.
You are the owner and sole proprietor of the Wizzo Chocolate Company?
I am.
Superintendent Parish and I are from the hygiene squad. We'd like to have a word with you about your box of chocolates entitled to the Wizzo Quality Assortment.
Oh, yes.
Let's begin at the beginning. First, we have the cherry fondue. Now this is extremely nasty. But we can't prosecute you for that.
Agreed.
Next we have number four. Crunchy frog.
Ah, yes.
Am I right in thinking that there's a real frog in here?
Yes, a little one.
What sort of frog?
A dead frog.
Is it cooked?
No.
What, a raw frog?
No. We use only the finest baby frogs, dew-picked and flown from Iraq, cleansed in the finest quality spring water, lightly killed, and then sealed in a succulent Swiss quintuple smooth treble creme milk chocolate envelope and lovingly frosted with glucose.
That's as may be, it's still a frog.
What else?
Don't you even bother to take the bones out?
If we took the bones out, it would be crunchy, would it?
Lieutenant Parrot ate one of those.
Oh, would you excuse me a moment?
It says crunchy frog quite clearly.
The superintendent thought it was an almond whirl. People aren't going to think there's a real frog in there. They're bound to think it's some sort of mock frog.
Mock frog? We use no artificial preservatives or additives of any kind.
Nevertheless, in the future, you should delete the words crunchy frog and replace them with the legend crunchy, raw, unboned, real, dead frog. If you want to avoid prosecution.
What about our sales?
I'm not interested in your sales. I have to protect the general public. What about this one? It was number five, wasn't it? Number five. Ram's bladder cup.
We use choicest, juicy chunks of fresh Cornish ram's bladder, empty, steamed, flavored with sesame seeds, whipped into a fondue, and garnished with lark's vomit.
Lark's vomit? Correct. But don't say nothing about that here.
Oh, yes it does, on the bottom of the box, right after monosodium glutamate.
I hardly think that's good enough. The box should bear a large red label that says, Warning, Lark's Vomit.
Our sales would plummet.
Why don't you move into more conventional areas of confectionery, like pralines or lime creams, which I understand are a very popular flavor. I mean, look at this one. Caramel crab. Cockroach cluster. Anthrax ripple.
Oh, that's our specialty. Covered in finest dark chocolate, when you pop it into your mouth, steel bolts spring out and plunge straight through both cheeks.
Where's the pleasure in that? If people pop a nice little choppy in their mouth, they don't want their cheeks pierced. In any case, it's a wholly inadequate description of the sweetmeat. I'm going to have to ask you to accompany me to the station.
It's a fair call.
And don't talk to the audience.
If only the general public could take more care when buying their sweeties, it would reduce the number of bad hours lost to the nation, and they would spend less time having their stomachs pumped and sitting around public laboratories.